Hello, Victor Nygren here. We are replaying the battle because the game crashed. I thought it would end the same, so I didn't record. But unfortunately, things took a different turn because the Stuka tactical bombers entered the city plaza and left the battle outside of the city. And without the bombers over there, they actually helped in killing a lot of tanks in the center instead. So the Soviet Union have lost a lot of their tanks or towers here, or bunkers. They have killed a lot of their tanks as well. The only unit still remaining here is the infantry bodyguard with the ram. And that's not a threat to our troops because we have Stuka strategic bombers and we have the general's bodyguard with the jeep still left. So the infantry will be easily taken care of. They sent in all their tanks and they all died. They have some tanks on the other side, but I believe we were successful at killing all their Yak-9 planes that entered the city. And we've killed a lot of their troops. They still have troops outside of the city, but it's just one tank, T-34 tank, and the infantry. I believe we will win this fight actually. We just need to sally out now and take care of them. So the first thing we will do is attack the army on the other side. The general of the weaker army with the 5 tanks and the rifleman bodyguard. We only have the rifleman left, so we will attack there. Don't need them to be under AI control, just attack. Walter Busch is still alive. I believe we have lost Heinz Guderian. So the Tiger 1 tanks have been taken out and our entire army here has been taken out. You can see the dead soldiers and tank carcasses there. But we won inside of the city. And we have the Stuka bombers. Unfortunately, I can't control them. They are AI controlled. So while they are great for defense, we can't use them to attack the troops outside. That's why we will attack the riflemen now with the jeeps and the riflemen. Probably won't even need to use the riflemen. The jeeps will take care of them themselves, I hope. I would be surprised if they fail. Here we have some farms. Church. Alright. Attack their weaker force first. Here we have the carcasses of the T-34 tanks taken out by the bunkers. We need to take out that rifleman unit there. And the jeeps have left the city. Are now posed to attack those infantry units. Bodyguard against bodyguard. They have quite a numbers here. Machine guns. They're about to fire at their rifleman bodyguard. Hopefully they will win. Yeah, they are taking down a lot of them. Let's fast forward. Their number of bodies are increasing. They spread out, make it harder for me to hit them. They have lost over half their troops already. Our infantry is now closing in on the outskirts of the city as well. 35 left, 69 left there. Now they decided to charge, I believe. Or at least they are walking away from the ram. And they have decided to fire back. But now they are only 34 left. They are charging now. Against the jeeps. And their general is dead! Pavel Ivanov died. Pavel Ivanov died, their only real general in this battle. The other one was a captain. Alright, we're done there. Now we just need to take out the T-34 tank, which would have been easy with the Stuka bombers. Maybe we could trigger it into moving if they fail at least. We have fast forward on. So now our armies just need to get to the other side of the city. I believe the jeeps will be faster than the infantry despite starting further away. So they move around the city, not through it. And we have the infantry moving through the city. 10 and 49 left. Well, the Stuka tactical bombers are just moving around, protecting the plaza there. AI was smarter this time and moved the Stukas to the plaza instead of having them wasted over here. In the other battle that I will still upload, they kind of all died here, being taken out by the fighter planes. I believe the jeeps took out the fighter planes this time. So, with their machine guns. Alright. The finale of the battle is about to start, and Kyiv was actually defended successfully, even if he lost Heinskiderian himself. Alright. But we won't be able to hold it if we are attacked again, which we probably will be. Tank is now under fire from the jeeps and it's about to fire back with its medium shells. The tank has started to fire against the jeep bodyguard. One of the jeeps have been taken out, two of them. Yeah, the tanks are kinda strong. Take out jeeps, three jeeps have been taken out. Their only hope of winning this battle, the jeep, the tank will win against the infantry, no doubt about it. But I'm not sure it will win against the jeeps. It might do it. Come on, bodyguard, if you take out that jeep, you have won. No, it was taken out. Yeah, the jeeps are nerfed compared to in the past. Alright, they took out our general here. And the general died. Walter Busch is dead. Our infantry is still moving there. They will be taken out as soon as they reach the tank. They are here. Means the battle is very, very close. If we could use the bombers we would have won, but I might be forced to, you know, exit the battle, and we will lose it again. Because these troops doesn't seem like they want to move. They might just stand here forever. We are sending the infantry there, but after they are defeated, I hope they will hunt them down. Otherwise, we have to forfeit the battle. So this battle was much more impressive in terms of the army defending, actually succeeding, taking out all the tanks. Unfortunately, I didn't record the beginning of the battle because I thought it would just be a repeat of the previous battle, and then it wasn't. So. So we are fast forwarding. Waiting for the infantry to reach the outskirts of the city. Can't see them yet. There they are, the infantry. Defenders of Kyiv here, occupied Kyiv. But the Ukraine, many Ukrainians actually wanted the Germans to liberate them from the Soviets because Stalin had purged a lot of their population, killed a lot of their citizens by starving them and such. So they very much were welcomed by many Ukrainians, but not everyone. They were also Ukrainians that didn't like the Germans, so. And the first unit has entered the area outside of the Siegfried Line wall and is about to soon start a skirmish with the tank here, the T-34 tank. And the tank is moving to face the infantry. I believe it will win easily against the first unit of just 10 infantry soldiers. Let's view it from their perspective. So they are fired at. They are already broken. Alright. Now we have at least made them move their tank here. The tank is now firing against the bigger unit of over 48 infantry units here. Come on, soldiers! If you take out that tank and the infantry, we will win. They are being fired at though, and seem to be going for the wrong unit. Fire at the tank, idiots! Continue to fire, maybe you will win. T-34 tank is firing back at the infantry. We have 39 left. They won! Yes! So they have 42 riflemen and we have 39 riflemen. So there will be riflemen versus riflemen now. Let's put them in loose formation. Fire at their infantry, so the finale will be infantry versus infantry. They had numerical advantage. I wonder why they are just standing there and not answering. Let's move them. Right. Fire at them! Fuck, they entered melee. No, we got broken. They decided to charge. Jesus Christ, they will probably hunt us now. I hope they will hunt all the way to the city plaza so the Stukas can take care of them. Stukas and... because they are our last hope now. They are following us, but I'm not sure they will actually follow the entire way to the city. Our armies are running away. So, the timer is ticking down. We could actually win. Because we hold the plaza, but that's weird, because we are the defender. We held it from the beginning. But yeah, it's still going down, so we will win in 2 minutes 28 seconds. No matter what. They are following our troops, but they are moving very slowly. They are walking. So our army has stopped. Let's fire. Turn around and fire. Right. So we have 23 left. They have 37. And the melee happened and they scared away our troops here. We have 20 left. They have 36 left. They won the melee because they had the miracle advantage. But we have our towers here, our bunkers. Firing at them. That's very good. 25 left. We have won. They couldn't even enter because our defenses were strong. Oh, some of them did enter. But only 11. They are weaker than our routing troops now. Close victory. So we won the second battle of Kiev. It's the same battle, but the last time I fought it, we actually lost. This time we won. You can see at the statistics here, when we view the statistics, Walter Busch had 297 defenders and he killed 448, that's very good. And we have 75 remaining after the battle, and he died. Heinz Guderian, great legendary general, he died and he had 180 men and they took out 170, so that's good. 41 left, only the Stuka planes were remaining. However, some of the units might have been restored as we won the battle. And the enemy armies under Pavel Ivanov and Captain Alexei, they had some troops left, but they failed. They killed about as many as in the last battle, but this time they didn't win. Look at the detailed statistics. This is what we can see, and let's continue. Yes, didn't crash. I have always considered Saipan the decisive battle of the Pacific offensive. It was the naval and military heart and brain of the Japanese defense strategy. Lieutenant General Holland M. Smith, commander of the U.S. Fleet Marine Force in the Pacific, July 1944. All right, so Kiev is still under German control. They did the impossible and won the defensive battle of Kiev. But the Soviet Union have even more armies they can send towards Kiev. So our defenders are in a bad situation. Let's move in the entire army there into the city and merge the troops. We have 2 BMW motorcycles that survived the battle, 5 Panzer IV, 5 Stuka tactical bombers, 8 assault infantry, 10 scout snipers, and 66 infantry. Alright. So Kiev managed to hold on. And he sent a great infantry force here to defend Minsk. I remember that. We had a revolt in Minsk from the rebels. So we move our army into one force there. Unfortunately, we can't do anything more this turn. Because we are next to an enemy and general here. Two generals. Nikolai Ivanov and Grigory Ivanov. All of them seem to be named Ivanov for some reason. Alright. End of turn report, we're no longer minus in profits, that's good. Faction announcements. Two heroic deaths. Walter Busch and Haynes Guderian. And we have diplomatic information. The following factions have declared they are allies. The Chinese Republic, that is the Kuomintang or the Nationalist China, have declared an alliance with the People's Republic of China, that is the Communist. That also happened in real history. They were allied to, during the Second World War and fought the Japanese together. Then they started a war against each other after the Japanese were defeated. Alright, and then they are also allied with Portugal now. Because Portugal has areas in Africa, in Europe, and in Asia. And then we have some agent detected here. Bulgaria. Alright. I wanted to move the army from Minsk to Kyiv in order to reinforce there, but they can't move. So we might not get there in time. Let's move the unit down there that we can. Don't really care about Kyiv. So we have some snipers there. The infantry can't reach the army, so they will stay in Kyiv and fight the last man. The rest have been moved here and merged with the army of Oscar Battle. General we got after winning a battle. So Kyiv is in the danger there. We have a market here. Right. So we can retrain troops. Actually I will retrain the assault infantry and the riflemen there. Market, we could keep it for now. No need to destroy it just yet. Merge the garrisons of Copenhagen and Oslo. Now they will enter the ships there. And we move the fleet towards Riga. We combine the fleet with the defeated fleet. The British fleet defeated. Right, so we have a stronger fleet now as the victorious fleet merged with the fleet that lost against Britain. And it has almost a full army, mostly infantry, but also two planes, Messerschmitt 109 planes, two units of BMW motorcycles, and two tank units, two Panzer I's. They are moving towards the front. They also had a lot of riflemen and two units of Waffen SS, two units of scout snipers, and yeah, that's it. They had some mechanized stuff that are very much needed at the front, but they also had some infantry. Alright, the army at Riga, what does it look like? I managed to click the wrong button. Alright, we have half an army there. Mostly infantry. So, 6, 6, 6. Alright. We have 4 units open there. 4 slots open. Actually, we should move it to Riga and reinforce with the Vesp artillery and the 2 tank units, I think. And some elite infantry. Then we have a new army. We have Warsaw there. Let's move a general to Warsaw and the other one to Brest. So we can help in the defense there. Now those two cities have governors. And the fleet is moving ever closer to Africa. U-boat fleet. is still far away. And this army will still stand there for now. I don't want to face the Italian army. They have one unit. Let's try to move past it. With Rommel's army there. So they moved through Zagreb. Are they going to reinforce what is its name? Tirana here, I believe so. Or they want to attack Belgrade. And we just entered with a general there. I'm not gonna let them do that. Leave some infantry units in Athens and move the rest towards Belgrade. So we have another army here. Alright. I want to talk to the other allies of mine. We will talk to Hungary next. Use the total diplomacy. So you will get their map information and they will have ours as well. They are going to help against the Soviet Union. Because they have a front against the Soviet Union and they helped historically. Alright. And do I want to give them anything? Don't want to yet to give them anything. Alright. Now we have their map information as well, so we know a little more of the world here. You can see Turkey, we have Istanbul here. And we have some areas, the Romanians, because the Hungarians had the Romanians on their map. And we have the Hungarian areas here, three areas. And Bulgaria there. Alright, so the map is a little more visible. We zoom in on the minimap, we can see more details here. Romania, Bulgaria, Hungary. So I wonder if we should do anything more here. Talk to anyone else. Let's move this diplomat towards Romania now. Unlike in Medieval 2, diplomats can talk to many factions in the same turn. In Medieval 2 you can only talk to one faction each turn. In Rome to the War you can talk to an unlimited number of factions, but you don't have unlimited numbers of moving points, so I still couldn't reach Romania this turn. Here we have a diplomat, French state with you, right. We have another diplomat. In order to easily find out, we will... No, I went to the building browser actually. We'll click here, and then show list scroll. And then we'll go to agents. We have two diplomats, as I knew we had. In Warsaw we have a second diplomat. It's kind of far off, but... Yeah, we are sending him towards Soviet. We need a map information from Soviet at least, because both factions should have a map information. Yes, back in the 1940s they had like maps over the entire world. It's just, it's okay. We have the British fleet here now, part of it. There are no troops or agents in it. Another fleet here. Lot of ships but no agents and no troops. Alright. So we have lost that front. Kiev is very weak. It will probably fall the next time they attack. We have a remnant army outside of Minsk because the Russians in Minsk, they revolted. And yeah, we will let the Soviets take care of the rebels, and we will try to retreat the army from this region unless it's attacked the next time. Alright, and now we will go to the building screen and see if we can build anything. So we have built the port at Berlin. Alright, aerodrome, etc. I think we have a small park here. Public health bonus. We'll build a small park first. We're trying to build the non-military buildings first. SPG training ground, we will get the Hummel to build it. Aerodrome will get us the U-88. Heavy bombers will also build it soon. Shipwright will give us more ships. I don't know exactly what we can recruit now. We can build troopers and Hermelins. And if we build the shipwright, we will get the Prince Eugen and the U-boats. So we will build that too soon. Heavy tank factory, then we get the Tiger 1s, and I believe we already have BMW motorcycles, and Panzer 4s and 1s. Yeah, we'll get the Tiger 1 if we build that. And the big Kasern will give us access to the Waffen SS. I believe we have the other stuff, the assault infantry and the scout snipers, yes. Alright, we are still recruiting or building anti-aircraft trucks there in Berlin. Let's check the other cities what we can build. Tunis, we could use a farm. In München we will get an airstrip, of course, that will enable us to build Stuka tactical bombers and Messerschmitt 109 fighting planes or fighter planes. And in Oslo we can't build anything, but we will recruit some assault infantry there. Hamburg, we are still building the airstrip there. Same in Frankfurt, Amsterdam, Brussels, Paris, Rouen, Bordeaux, something like that. In Kyiv, well, we will lose Kyiv soon, so I don't see the point. We can't destroy the farms. Small concern as a tip, let's destroy it. It will fall anyway. Destroy the market too, we won't leave it to the Soviets. I don't expect to keep it much longer. Alright, and go to the next city then. So we lost Minsk to rebels. Heraklion, we could actually could fast forward here and build some ships actually. One turn, two turns. Let's build a trooper, then we can move the ships immediately. We will do that in Heraklion. Could we build any buildings there, by the way? No, we couldn't. In Brest we could use a small concern that will give us the ability to recruit assault infantry. In Brest, the probably second Polish town or city on the map, out of two. Alright, in Riga, in the Baltic, we will build an airstrip. We need planes. Alright, in Athens, we will also, let's see here. We are recruiting scout snipers there, and yeah, we could build an airstrip there. Belgrade, we could also use an airstrip. 4, so we could use an airstrip. Zagreb, I don't know if we can do anything there. We are recruiting scout snipers there. Vienna, we could use another unit of riflemen and a small caserne, which will enable us to recruit the assault infantry. In Prague, we could build a small park. We are still building planes there. Small park in Stettin as well. Here we are also building planes. In Copenhagen we could use a small caserne. And we could recruit some riflemen to keep the order of the settlement. Now we are back in Berlin. We will go to the recruitment and see if we have missed any settlement. We are still building the anti-aircraft trucks in Berlin. But in Tunis we could use another unit of North Africa Assault Corps. In München we are building the Panzer IV tank. In Oslo we are recruiting an assault infantry unit. Hamburg a sniper unit. In Frankfurt a Panzer IV unit. And in Amsterdam we will recruit some scout snipers. In Brussels we could use scout snipers as well. And in Paris we are still training Stokes Mortar Artillery crews. And then in Rouen we will get another assault infantry unit. In Bordeaux we will get a unit of riflemen. And in Brest, Poland, we will get a rifleman unit. Yeah. In Riga we were recruiting scout snipers, in Athens we were recruiting scout snipers. In Belgrade we'll get another unit of riflemen. In Warsaw we could actually use another, no, we will get a rifleman unit there. It's pretty close to the front. And I believe we are done this time. Can we move anything? I don't think so. Don't have any ships to retreat the army here in Tunis. We have moved Erwin Rommel. Yeah, we could click next turn now. So Riga is under siege, and Kyiv too. They will probably attack Kyiv immediately. Fortunately, I destroyed all the buildings that I could destroy, so even if Soviet takes the city, they won't be rewarded with any intact buildings that are buildable or destroyable. Alright, they have a Yak 9 fighter plane here, they have some tanks, they have infantry. So some of their units have been in battle. We have very few units left. Don't bother, there will be an automatic battle here. We had no chance at all. Our remnants had zero chance to win that. Alright, they didn't attack at Minsk this time. And Minsk is held by rebels anyway. Candidate for adoption, Theodor Model, but I don't want the general with Hitler's portrait, so we will decline that general. Alright, we have an army under Leonid Petrov here. Yak 9 planes and at least two starting armies of T-34 tanks besieging Riga. That's not good because I had planned to merge the army in Riga with the army in this fleet. Let's disembark the troops here. What about this? No. We weren't backed up by the other army. But if we attack with this army, we are actually getting back up. They have two units of Yak 9 planes and two starting armies of T-34 tanks. Let's wait with that attack too. Recruitment report. In Berlin we have a new anti-aircraft truck. In Frankfurt we have Panzer IVs, in Vienna we have riflemen, in München we have Panzer IV. In Hamburg we have scout snipers, etc, etc, etc. We have lots of new troops this time. That's good, but mostly infantry, unfortunately. Faction announcements. Marriage celebrations. Oscar Battle and Walter Graf have retinue expand. He has had his retinue expanded. Yeah. Alright, and then we have end of turn report. We are... We earned 2,609 in profits. No longer minus. Agent detected Romania had sent spies into our lands. It was detected. Settlement occupied Kyiv was occupied as expected. And the settlement besieged Kyiv. Yeah, it was besieged and then occupied. And Riga is under siege. We will fight the battle outside of Riga as we have a new army. Fresh from Copenhagen, the capital of Denmark, and Oslo, the capital of Norway. Fresh from those cities that will aid in defending Riga from Leonid Petrov's army here. Alright, we have another army outside of the rebel-held area of Minsk, or settlement of Minsk. It will move back towards the Polish town of Brest. So we have retreated, we have 5 units of riflemen and 1 unit of jeeps here. Right, we don't need to place the army there. The entire army, we will just move past the city. A diplomat here, Romania. Let's move the diplomats towards the Union instead. I want to save, because sometimes the game can actually game lock if you try to use the total diplomacy function. I don't want that to happen when I recorded and spoken and all that. So we are saving and show me how. And we will get map information and give them map information. We won't do anything else. This is the enemy after all. The Soviet Union. You can see now we have the Soviet Union on the map. They have areas in the Asian theater as well. Half their countries in Asia. Alright. So this is the Soviet Union. Kind of vast. All these areas. Even an area down here. And then they have areas on the other side of the Atlantic as well. So they are a huge faction. Alright, so now they know where we are on the map and we know where they are on the map. Alright. Let's move the diplomat towards Finland. We need their information and stuff too. Because we have our ally Finland over here. Helsinki. Have a new trooper here outside of Heracleion. Let's move the ships towards Tunis. Try and evacuate the troops there. The U-boat fleet is now moving in as well. And has entered this the sound of Gibraltar, I believe. Yeah. And then we have some troops here. Scare away the enemy there. Let's keep them there. We have a diplomat that will now go towards Romania. I believe Romania is first, then Bulgaria, and then Turkey. Show help. Show me how. Want their map information, and they want ours. And we will ask for help against the Soviet Union. They did help historically. And we will also promise to attack. Alright, and... that's it. So we have Romania on the map. They have three areas there. The capital of Bucharest is here. We move directly to Bulgaria now. We didn't reach them, we almost reached them. Their capital is Sofia here. Tsar Boris III is there in the city. They have three units of assault infantry, two units of anti-tank infantry, they are pretty good, and a Stokes mortar artillery unit. Alright, the larger army is here. Alright, Hungary has a border with the Soviet Union and an army there as well. I'm afraid Kharkov has been taken by the Soviet Union, so the Italians are defeated and no longer shares a border with the Union. Hungary still stands too, at least according to this map. It might be outdated. Alright. So what can we do now? Move the fleet closer to home. And we will take a look at the structures, the buildings again. See if we can build anything new this time, this turn. I don't think there are a lot to build, but maybe one or two areas have something we can build. Otherwise, we are already constructing buildings in all the regions, yeah. I think we are constructing in every region, yes. So, now to the recruitment then. What should we recruit? Messerschmitt fighter plane could be used, so yeah, we'll build some planes. And in München, we will build some Panzer IVs. Oslo will get some more assault infantry. In Hamburg, we'll get some Panzer I's. In Frankfurt, we'll get, let's see, I will get another Panzer IV there. In Amsterdam, we will get, we already are recruiting some snipers there. Same in Brussels. In Paris, we will get the Stokes mortar artillery unit. In Rouen, we will get another assault infantry. In Bordeaux, we will get a rifleman. In Heracleion, we will get another assault infantry unit. In Brest we'll get another rifleman unit because we had no other choice. In Riga we'll get a Stokes mortar artillery unit. And in Athens we'll get scout snipers. In Belgrade we'll get another rifleman unit. And in Warsaw we'll get another rifleman unit. In Zagreb we'll get a scout sniper unit. Vienna will get a rifleman unit. And in Prague we will get a Stuka tactical bomber unit. And instead we will now build another Messerschmitt 109 plane unit, fighter unit. Copenhagen will get rifleman. And we're back in Berlin. Alright. Now the question is, have we any troops that we can move? Yeah, we had Erwin Rommel there. He will move closer towards Tunis to try and merge with this army here. And hopefully the fleet can evacuate them then after that. And we will also evacuate this army. And give Tunis to Italy as well. Do they still hold this territory? Yes. They got a large force for they got it automatically when we gave them the city, so in essence they reinforced the city when we gave it to them. That's good in Rome Total War, that they give troops to the factions when you give a region, so it's not empty. Right. Here we have the Vichy French, their diplomat, and probably an Italian diplomat here. This army can't move anymore this time. Alright. We don't have any other armies to move around. We might have some troops to move from cities though. We need the troops defending Brest and Warsaw. Planes to move immediately to Vienna there. From Stettin. And these planes could also move immediately to Zagreb. So 15 units there and 14 units here. Yeah, and the anti-aircraft trucks could move to Vienna. Move one unit of riflemen to Zagreb. To give 15 units to each city. This army has a general. Ewald Donitz. Well, Zagreb is without a governor or general. Alright. Berlin only have Hitler. Now they have a general there. Let's move him to Vienna then. Then move Ewald Donitz to Zagreb. Both cities have commander now. Here we have another general, Felix Battle. And then the army led by Gunther Altebung here. Prague we have 4 units of riflemen. Hamburg we have now scout snipers that will move to Frankfurt. Panzer force in Frankfurt, but I will move them to München. And in Amsterdam we have some assault infantry. We could move to Brussels actually. And in Brussels we have a few troops too. Rouen. It's 11 troops, 10 troops, 10 troops. Paris, alright. We don't have that many in Bordeaux. I believe we won't do anything more this turn. Alright, we will attack with this army. We'll attack Leonid Petrov here. Save the battle. Needed to attack, otherwise they would attack the city and we wouldn't have a reinforcing army aiding in the battle, so we would lose probably. It's better to fight on the battlefield with both armies. The AI will be in control of the defending army that will sally out from the city, and we will be in control of this reinforcement army from Oslo and Copenhagen. Alright. Start the battle. I speak in the name of the entire German people when I assure the world that we all share the honest wish to eliminate enmity that brings far more cost than any possible benefits. Adolf Hitler, 14th October 1933. Yeah, that was a lie. Alright. Start deployment. So we have this army here under our control. We have Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes. 2 units of Messerschmitts. Then we have some infantry, BMW motorcycles, Panzer 1s. Yeah, and that's it. 2 units of Panzer 1s, 2 units of BMW motorcycles, and 2 units of Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes. The rest are infantry. Mostly riflemen. We have 2 units of Waffen-SS and 1 unit of scout snipers as well. Let's place them in group formation and then loose formation and under AI control, I don't care. Start the battle, pause the battle, and then we need to click on the enemy. They have lots of T-34 tanks, they have the miracle advantage in both tanks, maybe not infantry, but tanks. But their infantry units are more numerous than ours, so we get reinforcements from the army inside of Riga under Captain Oscar. Yeah, let's see how it will go. This is the army from Oslo and Copenhagen, freshly arrived to the battlefield of the Eastern Front. Really needed to evacuate those troops from Norway and Denmark to fight the Soviets, which is more important. Might not be the best troops, but they are still better than no army at all. We almost have no armies left to defend. It was very much needed here. I think the Soviets are retreating. No, they regrouped to this area. Oh, look at the road. Modern road. Here in Riga. Awesome. Because we built modern roads there. You also have the farms. Vanilla buildings that were buildable. So modern roads stretching the entire map. That's a nice sight. It adds to the immersion having modern roads like that. It means we have left Ukraine and entered the Baltic. Army is now moving forward. Well, the reinforcing army is still far from entering the battlefield. They have some troops here. Some Vesper artillery, I see. Let's move back to our army. So the scout snipers are marching forward there. Well, the rest of the army has stopped in their tracks. They are moving now. Hopefully these forces will be able to stop the Soviets for a while, until we can move even more troops from Africa and Greece. The scout snipers will soon be able to fire upon the enemy with their long range rifles. Our Panzer Ones, unfortunately, are not that good. They are kind of weak against their medium tanks, the T-34. So we didn't have any Panzer force in these occupational forces. Norway and Copenhagen were held by the most early tanks and such, all types of artillery, infantry, but not any better than Panzer Ones, I see. And some BMW motorcycles, of course, they had that. No general either. Where are the Soviets? The Soviets, actually, they retreated, their army. They escaped from Riga. Here their infantry is about to leave the battlefield. Our tanks are almost... they've almost catched them there. Here they have reached the border. The motorcycles and the tanks. Or panzers. Alright, they left. So we managed to protect Riga with our reinforcement troops. They decided to retreat. So, that's that battle. We killed 9 of their troops, they killed 6 of ours. Alright, probably infantry. Here are the full stats decks. Not much of a battle. But at least we managed to break the siege of Riga. Yes, it didn't crash. Yeah. I've already read that, I believe. It's about the Hitler and Mussolini aiding Spain during the Spanish Civil War. Yeah. I would say to the house, as I said to those who have joined this government, I have nothing to offer but blood, salt, tears and sweat, Winston Churchill. Alright. It didn't crash this time. The battle ended the same way, the Soviet army retreated, and the siege of Riga were broken. Now we can reinforce the army. Of course the armor will be added to this army. We need all the armor units we could get. Then we will also add the scout snipers of this force here. I don't want riflemen if I can add anything better. So we'll move in the riflemen into the city and add the scout snipers and the assault infantry instead to the army. And we have a new full army here. And this army has no general. Right. We will move in one unit of riflemen to the city. And move the general, the governor of Brest, he will be moved to this army here. Right. He won't necessarily need to move this time from Riga, we could keep him there for now. So we have a new army here with a general. Ernst Dissel has been appointed leader or commander of this army. Freshly arrived from Copenhagen and Oslo. They will partake in the defense of Germany. The front is now moved to the Baltic. We have another army here, retreating army, will enter Brest. Can't move any more this time, I see. Some of the units can move. And we will move them. I believe only the artillery cannot move. We move the rest inside of Brest. And merge troops. We have full army now defending Brest, but mostly infantry. We have few Stuka tactical bombers, and a few Panzer IVs, and a few BMW motorcycles. And they have 2 Vesp artillery units outside. But Brest is at least heavily defended now, even if it's a sucky army. Alright, Soviet still needs to defeat Hungary here in Kursk. Kursk, where the great tank battle were held in 1943. We'll see if we get there by that time. Alright, and then Minsk is held by rebels, neutrals, so Soviet Union will have to defeat them as well. We will keep this army outside of Riga for now. The front will have to be there. And we can't move this either. So we have another front at Brest. And then we are protected by Hungary and Romania here. So the Soviet Union won't be a threat to Athens or Belgrade anytime soon. Right. That limits the front down to 2 areas. the rest of the battles will be against our allies now, but we could still be betrayed. Alright. We probably have already moved this turn, so it's time to click next turn actually. Belgrade. We have an army that reached Belgrade under Gunther Alterbung have reached Belgrade, I see. We have no interest in moving in any troops. They could use a few more troops in the army. And another turn. Civil revolt in Brest. Poland has revolted here, despite our full army there. Let's move out the worst of the troops. Infantry. We have 5 snipers, that's nothing, but still believe the assault infantry is better. Move out. Let's move two units to Warsaw then. And the Vesp artillery to the Great Army. And move that unit to Warsaw. And we will move the army towards Warsaw for now. Soviet will need to take out the rebels in both areas. Move the diplomat towards the Finnish border. So we have two areas with rebels protecting us from the Soviets here. We will no doubt take them sooner or later. We will let them take care of those armies. That means the front for our part moved to war, so here we have a lot of infantry. Capital of Poland. Alright. Civil revolt in Brest. No. Candidate for adoption. Benefactor Theodore Model. Yes, we will accept that. Agent detected. Hungary had a spy in our lands. Doesn't matter. End of turn report. We earned as much as 12,260. This turn. That was much better than the prior turn. Alright, marriage celebrations. Ernst Dissel has been married to Hannah. Construction report. We have a lot of new buildings now. In Berlin we have a small park. In Frankfurt we have an airstrip. In Vienna we have a small caserne. In Hamburg we have an airstrip. In Copenhagen we have a small caserne. The small caserne allows us to recruit assault infantry. The airstrip will allow us to build Stuka tactical bombers and Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes. We have also an airstrip in Rouen and a small caserne in Brest. Unfortunately, Brest revolted, so it ended up in the hands of rebels. And then we have a small park in Stettin, a small park in Prague, and we have airstrips in Brussels, Amsterdam, Paris and Bordeaux. So we can build planes from a lot of areas now. The most early planes. Still better than no planes, and they are still better than all the tanks, so yeah. So we have path blocked for the diplomat Felix von Kutschler. Adoption not completed, have a battle, alright. And our fleet here can move back. Port of Berlin. Here we will station it for now. Could talk to which France, but I'm more interested in talking to Bulgaria now. So let's talk to Bulgaria. Let's save the game first in case it game locks or something. I don't like when that happens, you know, and I need to replace stuff. Alright, and show me how. We'll get their map information, of course, and they will get our map information. Bulgaria, we want your help against the Soviet Union. We will also aid you. And that's it. Now we have Bulgaria here. Right, I'm planning on giving Athens and Heraklion to Turkey, but I don't want to do that until we have removed our troops from the region. Let's talk to Turkey as well. A neutral faction. The only thing we will use against them, they won't be able to refuse, is the map information. And trade rights, they had that too. Alright, that's all. Otherwise we will not use total diplomacy. We will let them suggest an alliance. So we have the second Soviet fleet here. It's locked inside of the Black Sea here, but they are outside of the Bulgaria docks and Turkey docks here. Have some good battleships, the Moskva battleship, Moscow in Swedish and in Russian are Moskva. So yeah, that's the name of their capital, just in their language. Alright, we have a Turkish army here, by the way. Let's take a look at it. So they have riflemen. We have Fiat 3000 tanks, same as Italy's worst tank. And then they have armored officer's car. Right. The reason I want to give Athens and Heraklion to Turkey is because they're neutral. So they will most likely fight the Bulgarians and the Romanians, keeping them busy, so they won't attack me from another front, because I need to focus on Russia or Soviet Union. So Turkey could be made a little stronger to keep my smaller allies busy with Turkey. That's my idea, at least. Plus Turkey didn't like Greece. But they did have an alliance with Greece, in the sense Bulgaria would attack. They promised to help Greece in this war, but not when Germany intervened. That was as long as it was Bulgaria and Italy. Yeah. All right. So we are moving a diplomat up towards the Finnish front or border. We are leaving that arm here to defend. I don't want to sacrifice him. Will defend Riga, and this second army will defend Warsaw to the last man. We have an army here, moving him back in case the Italians want to try something. Alright, we will move this army very close to the Italian army in case they are about to do something bad there, in case they want to betray us. They still have a huge fleet here with some troops in it as well. Right, we're going to move Erwin Rommel closer to Tunis. When I think about it, we could probably retreat Rommel now. He will enter the fleet and then move on towards Tunis there. So we have room for at least 14 additional units. How many do we have in Tunis? We have 13 units, so yeah, we could evacuate the entire city. We'll do that the next time. Hope no one will attack my troopers there. So our great fleet is about to reach Alger. The U-boat fleet is also soon in Tunis. Unlike the transport, it will be able to protect. I'm afraid this transport will be attacked and sunk. The U-boat fleet is more safe, so it will be better to place the army in the U-boat fleet. We will see about that. Hope they won't sink Erwin Rommel. That someone will attack me and sink Erwin Rommel the next time. I don't want that. Anyway, let's see if we have anything else to do. We will probably have to build some buildings now that a lot of buildings were completed. So let's do that now. In Berlin, as an example, to build a medium park. Alright, we will build a medium park in Berlin. In Tunis, we are still building farms. And in München, an airstrip. Honestly, we can't build anything. Hamburg, we will build a small park. And in Frankfurt, yeah, we could build a small park there as well. And in Amsterdam, well, let's build a small park there as well. Civilian buildings first. Small park in Brussels. And in Paris as well. Small parks in Rouen. In most areas we will build small parks. All areas where we can. Can't build anything in Heracleion. In Riga we are already building stuff. In Athens and Belgrade and Warsaw. Zagreb we can't build anything. Vienna we can't build anything either. In Prague we will build civil headquarters. It will give us access to spies as well and public order bonuses. Alright, that's Prague. Capital of Czechoslovakia, I believe. Stettin, a German city. We will build the civil headquarters there as well. And we're back in Berlin. Now it's time to go for the units. We're still building some Messerschmitts there. In Tunis we could use another North Africa Corps unit. So we will lose the region soon anyway. And in Oslo we'll build another Assault Infantry unit. In Hamburg we will continue to construct the tank. Yeah. Frankfurt as well. In Amsterdam we now can build planes. We will build a Messerschmitt 109 in Amsterdam and a Stuka tactical bomber in Brussels. In Paris we are still recruiting the Stokes mortar for now, so the planes will have to wait. In Rouen we will construct a... No, we need a tactical bomber. We already had a unit of Messerschmitt 109 fighters. Now we need a tactical bomber of Stukas there. In Bordeaux we could use Messerschmitt 109 fighters. And in Heracleion we could use another assault infantry unit. In Riga we are already training Stokes mortar crews. Athens we are training scout snipers. And in Belgrade we will get another unit of riflemen. Warsaw, we could use another unit of diplomats there, I think. I need another unit of diplomats to send towards Vichy, France and Spain, etc. Alright, Zagreb, we are already building there, recruiting, etc. In Vienna, we will get another unit of assault infantry. And in Copenhagen, we will get another unit of assault infantry as well. And we're done! Now it's the question is if we can move any troops. We are moving Erwin Rommel towards Tunis and the U-boat fleet. The two armies outside, one outside of Warsaw and one outside of Riga. And we have an army here to scare away the Italians. They only have a general here. Italo Garibaldi faction air. Italy Garibaldi. Right. Italian army in Bulgarian lands here. Family member, Virgilio de Campo. Alright. I believe it's next turn. We can't do anything more this turn. So we will click next turn. Three French are attacking us somewhere. Alright, the ships. Let's save. I don't want to lose urban Rommel. That's the problem with the transport, it had only one ship. If I lose, I will load the save and try to escape. Clear victory! Awesome! Good job, Admiral Wilhelm. So Admiral Figaro of the Free French lost. He had about the same strength. One unit of ships. We're afraid that something else would attack, like the Italian Great Fleet or the Vichy French, etc. Candidate for adoption, benefactor Theodore Model. Yes. And then we have agent detected. Hungary had a spy in our lands and it was detected. Agent detected Hungary, they had two spies, alright. End of turn report, we earned 1767 this turn, not as much as the previous turn, but we lost Brest as well. And we built a lot of stuff. Alright, faction announcements. New family member, Ulrich Graf, and Retinue expands, Felix Battle. Construction report, we have a lot of airstrips built. In München, in Athens, in Riga, in Warsaw, and in Belgrade. Then we have farms plus one in Tunis as well. Diplomatic information. Following factions are now at war with each other. The British Commonwealth of Nations, also known as the British Empire, is at war with Bulgaria, an Axis power. And the following factions have declared a ceasefire. Bulgaria is now at peace with the Free French, also known as the French Republic. And Hungary has also declared peace with the French and with the British Commonwealth of Nations. Are they preparing to betray me, maybe? Making peace with my enemies. Alright, I'm recruiting some units as well. Got a lot of new troops this turn. And our U-boat fleet will move forward there. Fuck! I wanted it to... We landed Urban Rommel in Tunis for now and merged the troops. We have a full army there now. But it's not good that we got stuck here. I hoped I would prevent that from happening, actually. So the USA has won trooper here, Chester. Oh, I see. This is like the Hermelin, I believe. Fuck, should I restart? Because I wanted this fleet to reach Port of Tunis now. No, I will blockade then. For now. So we delayed the moving there. We delayed that situation a little. Let's move this trooper back towards Heracleion. Here's the fleet that we defeated, I believe. Admiral Figaro or something, yes. That sucked that we didn't manage to avoid that port. I should have clicked slightly above and moved him straight here. Because I wanted to give Tunis to the Italians. And move this army this turn towards Greece. So we have the great Italian fleet moving around here. Italian army has moved from here. They are about to attack us here. About to attack Belgrade, the capital of Yugoslavia. Forget that, we're sending the army there. Soviet Union has arrived in the territory of the Riga settlement. Riga, it's probably the capital of Lithuania or something, or Estland, something of some of those. Something of those. Anyway, we have full army here under Konstantin Ivanov and Nikolai Petro. And we have another army with Katyusha rocket trucks under George Shukov, a known general. So there are two huge armies marching towards Riga. We only have one army here. Actually, it would be good to attack them. That would be very good. Let's not move all of them. Move most of the troops. We will attack with one unit. This way we can take out one army. Hopefully. So they can't attack with both armies at once. What do they have? Assault infantry, scout snipers, anti-tanks. They have two jeep bodyguards, I believe, or they are rifleman bodyguards, something of that short. They have T-34 tanks, they have MS-1 tanks, and more infantry. Yeah, nothing futuristic at least. Still a dangerous army, and we can't face both of them at once. If we lose that battle, Riga is lost. We will lose the Baltic as well. Soviet is still holding Leningrad. And they seem to have taken the area of Petrozavodsk from Finland as well. Finland only has its capital now, Helsinki. We entered Finnish lands with a diplomat. We will have to wait until next turn before we can talk or speak to the Finnish. Finnish have a capital here. There is probably a city. Alright, so the Soviet Union is planning to go around the neutrals here and attack Riga. We have Warsaw here, with a new diplomat. Let's move that diplomat towards the east. And this army, I think it will just have to stand there for now. Won't move any further. Italians are about to attack the Turks, a neutral faction. That's fine by me. In their quest to restore Rome, of course they want this area too. Alright. Can't give Greece Heraklion yet. We need to evacuate our troops from this island first. Same with Athens. We need to first land our troops here and move them out of here. Then we can give it to Turkey. But Tunis, I would have been able to give Tunis to the Italians now, if it weren't for my mistake with the ships there. Alright, let's see if we can move anything around. Spanish state diplomat outside of Vienna. We have two generals here. One of them should move, I think. Let's move on to Prague. And instead we have planes moving them to Vienna. Berlin, we should have something new. We have planes there as well. We have Stukas here. Move them to Zagreb then. Messerschmitt 109th there. Move to Vienna. We won't move anything in Prague. We have some Panzer Ones in Hamburg. Could move to München. Panzer IVs in Frankfurt. They could also move to München. And in Amsterdam we have some infantry, but I don't bother moving anyone there. Could you keep them there? In Bristol. Could keep the units there as well. The units of Paris. Yeah, and then Rouen. We won't move the French units yet. München, how many did we have there? Lot. Right. So we have 13 units in Herculean. We have almost an army in Tunis. Alright, let's see what we can build. We are building a medium park in Berlin. In Tunis. Yeah, we will build an airstrip, I guess, to help the Italians out. In München we will get the civil headquarters. And then we'll see about the rest of the cities here. Here we can build something. In Riga. Well, we are about to get fucked there, maybe. But upgrades light weapons and upgrades heavy weapons. Yeah, let's build a small tank factory. We can also recruit Panzer Ones there, that's good. Let's build it in Athens. We could actually build a small park. Belgrade. We could get some cobblestone roads. And in Warsaw we could get some asphalt roads now. And we're back in Berlin. Now it's time to recruit troops. So, as we can see, we have a few units to choose from. I think yeah, we will go for the Stuka bombers now. We need planes. In München we could get some Messerschmitt 109 fighters. Oslo we can get some more of the assault infantry units. In Hamburg we can get some Stukas. In Frankfurt we'll get some more of the Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes. And in Paris we'll get some Stukas. Rouen already is building, same with Bordeaux. Herculean will get another unit of assault infantry. And in Riga, of course, we'll get some planes. I think the best unit against tanks are the Stukas, we'll get that. But against other planes, we need the fighters. Alright, and in Athens, we could get some fighter planes. In Belgrade we'll get some Stukas. In Warsaw we'll get some Messerschmitt fighters. Then Zagreb we'll get some assault infantry. Some assault infantry in Vienna as well. And in Prague we are going to build some Stukas. Instead we could use the Messerschmitt fighters instead. And in Copenhagen we will get some assault infantry. And we're back in Berlin. Now it's just about time to fight the battle here against the first Soviet army that dared enter our lands here. I have no idea how many armies they have left of that huge wall of armies. They also have the ability to recruit new stuff, so probably have a lot to throw our way. They have a huge army over here as well. Under Piotr Petrov. Right. So we need to limit their armies. Here we have Pat blocked the diplomat Felix von Kachler. Right. So let's start the battle. But first we need to save. So Ernst Diesel has 599 men. Captain Gerd has almost as many, 505, but they are mostly infantry, and then we have 81 riflemen ourselves. Start the battle. Play the battle on the battle map. Everything about the behavior of American society reveals that it's half Judaized. The other half is negrified. Adolf Hitler, January 1942. Yeah, he had some prejudice against America. He also underestimated their power and their industry. At least the Japanese knew about their power, but attacked them anyway, thinking that if they took out the fleet, they would be powerless to do anything. But they were too fast to build it up again. Alright, start deployment. They built it up too fast. The Japanese expected the American fleet to you know, be out long enough for them to conquer the Asian theater. Alright. So we will place the riflemen in loose formation and start the battle. They will just defend, they won't move. So we have the Soviet army here. Lots of T-34 tanks as usual. And the infantry. Stretching the entire front here. But no planes this time, I think. And they will kill off our riflemen there. Very soon. Some planes entered battle. Our Messerschmitt 109 planes have arrived. They're firing at them. Fortunately, some of them might be shot down before the rest of the army arrives. That usually happens because they are so few. All the tank projectiles will be thrown at them at once. We have modern roads here. So we are close to Riga, capital of either Estland or Lithuania, I'm not sure. And the army is coming here, the army that we sent from Copenhagen and Oslo, as well as some extra infantry units from Riga itself. They're garrisoned in Riga. Only the planes are currently fighting. They might be shot down before the rest of the army arrives. We have our infantry also being fired at now. They are probably broken, so they are shaken currently. Being fired at from the tanks. The tanks will no doubt choose to drive over them soon. They are a sideshow. But our planes are the real fight here. Alright! The army need to do something. Probably they are waiting for the other armies to first be defeated. And the problem is that my planes will be shot down before the army decides to intervene. They probably are waiting for this army to first be defeated. and my unit of riflemen. Because this is a third army of only riflemen. Ah, they are moving up. The troops. Some SS there, Panzer 1s, Jeeps and BMW motorcycles, even more tanks here. Here we have some tanks without turrets, Panzer 4s as usual. For some reason the Panzer 4s are without turrets, but not the others. Maybe the Panzer 4s didn't get the fix that the others did get. I'm not sure. Degwax did something to fix that issue, or make it less common. But I believe the Panzer 4s have it quite often, while the other tanks don't seem to be affected as much. It seems my infantry are only 33 men left now. So the planes aren't defeated yet. We have a Messerschmitt here. Still firing on them from the air. T-34 tanks that close to the German army. Right, we have more of our planes here in the back, that's good. Have at least 3 planes still flying. The Panzer 1 seem to also be affected, but haven't happened as often. Here is one with the turret still on. Here we have some Panzer 1s, all of them look good. Modern roads here as well. There's a hill there, so it didn't look that good. We have lots of infantry in this battle as well. See what happens. The statistics are clearly on our side. So we have lost 6%, they've lost 36%. The battle is going well. Very good, because they have an almost endless number of armies. So even if we win, they have the upper hand, but I think they will retreat now to the other army. They realized that they were getting their ass handed to them and that they needed to retreat in order to be able to attack with both their armies instead. They have another army further back, so they strategically retreated again. Usually they do that if we have planes and they don't, because the tanks aren't as good, so they will view the planes as dangerous. Look at this, lot of tanks moving around along the entire front there. We won this battle because they retreated in the end, but we took out 36% of their troops, maybe more now. 40% of the enemy, I believe some of them also count when they have retreated. So 38% were, or 36% were killed, that's for sure. Then I don't know, the rest are probably retreated. I don't want to face both of their armies. They might actually win. Maybe I need to move the second army to this front so they can be 2 against 2. Yeah. I have some infantry still here. The anti-tank unit also trying to retreat. Their infantry, unlike the other units, are not that fast. They might all be shot down from the planes before they can manage to leave the battlefield. Enemy general fallen, so they lost their general, a rifleman general, no doubt. Lul. Panzer 4s. severe broken since before. Alright, they had fought before in past battles. Maybe it's because they were remnants of earlier battles. Tanks that have been in earlier battles and that have been like almost defeated, and then they are restored. Like if there are 5 tanks left and you use that in a battle, then they usually don't have their turret anymore. All the fresh tanks have turrets. Not the remnants for some reason. Alright. If these Panzer ones were fresh. So we are still firing at the infantry that didn't manage to leave in time. It's a good result. We took out most of their infantry and a lot of their tanks as well. In order to avoid those tanks without turrets, I need to destroy all the tanks that survive battles if they are badly damaged, if the unit is almost defeated. We even have some planes still in the air. Here we have 2 Messerschmitts, I believe we have another one over there. We didn't have any Stukas in this battle. Alright, and lots of infantry. We're aiding in the battle as well. Snipers. SS. Alright. Tanks are moving forward. Including the broken tanks. Some BMVs. Yeah, we should win any minute now or second. Unit routes. We've reached the border. They have one unit here still trying to leave. Assault infantry, I see. They are being fired at, they will probably be killed. Continue the battle. Try to kill all of them. Yeah, we did kill all of them. And we have won the battle! Even though they managed to retreat a lot of their tanks. Clear victory! So our army killed as many as they were. They were 599 deployed and they killed 599 of the enemy. They have 572 remaining. Our rifleman unit killed 40. We are 88 units in total in their one unit of riflemen. That was good, and then we had a backup army of 505 riflemen and they killed only 24. That was bad. But they also have most of their units remaining. They only lost 3. And the enemy had 896 units, including many T-34 tanks. They killed 73 of our troops and have 271 remaining. So it was really bad for their army, at least. Alright. Mussolini is quite humiliated because our troops have not moved a step forward. Even today they have not succeeded in advancing and have halted in front of the first French fortification, which put up some resistance. Count Ciano, Italian foreign minister, written in his diary, 21st June 1940. I hate when this happens. If it's CTD,